sing it again. Pour it out.
The first thing God did for man after man was created was to give him a helper. God said, in response to Adam's inquiry, he said, I see everybody is two, I'm one. He said, well, Adam, I'll make a helpmate for you. I will. So Adam gave names to all the cattle, to the best of the air, and to every beast of the field. But for Adam, there was not found a helpmate. God bless you. God bless you. In Jesus' name, amen. Yeah, there was not found a helpmate for him. And then what happened? To the next verse, please. And the Lord God caused a deep sleep to fall upon Adam, and he slept. And he took one of his ribs, closed up the flesh instead thereof. So there was no helper for Adam. He goes to God and says, God, I don't have a helper. God says, Adam, I will make a helpmate for you. I will make a helper for you. Everybody needs a helper. I'm talking about divine helpers. Everybody needs a helper. Do you know, before Jesus went away, he said, when I go, I won't leave you alone. I will send you the Holy Spirit, the helper. First thing God gave to man was a helpmate. First thing Jesus gave to man before he left us to go back to the Father was a helper. Because he knows that without a helper, you and I can't do anything. Look through your life. Somebody helped you to get to where you are. Everybody was helped by somebody. Whether big or small. Whether a help that you didn't solicit or a help that you solicited. Whether a help that came by way of pain or by gain. Whether a help that came through negative experiences that made you a positive person. But whatever happened, somebody helped you. You need a helper. And as we talk about divine helpers, I'm asking God that in this session, that you will begin to have one hunger. That's, God, send me my helpers. I want to talk to you about Jacob. Jacob. You know, before he was born, Rebecca went to the place of prayer. Listen to this carefully. And God told Rebecca, two peoples are in your womb. Two nations are in your womb. The younger will be stronger than the older. And in fact, the younger will serve the older. God prophetically, God supernaturally spoke to Rebecca. You can find it in Genesis 25, 23. And the Lord said to her, two nations are in your womb. Two peoples shall be separated from your body. One people shall be stronger than the other. And the older shall serve the younger. This was a prophetic word. God spoke concerning Jacob. That Jacob, even before you were born, I'll make sure that you'll be stronger than your brother. And your brother will serve you. In fact, in Malachi, it talks about Esau I love, Jacob I hate. Malachi chapter 1, verse 2. Yes, 2 and 3. It says, I have loved you, says the Lord. Yet you say, in what way have you loved us? Was not Esau, Jacob's brother, says the Lord. Yet Jacob I have loved, but Esau I have hated, and laid waste his mountains and his heritage for the jackals of the wilderness. So Jacob had a prophecy over his life. God has spoken over Jacob. God had said to Jacob, number one, through Rebecca. And number two, through a direct prophetic word from Malachi, referring to a conversation God would have told Malachi as a prophet, that I told Esau that I loved, I hate him, and I told Jacob that I loved him. So with this prophecy hanging over his neck, you would think that Jacob would not have to do anything. There would be no need of a helper. If God said it, it will come to pass, like many of us say.
But look at what happened. Now it came to pass, I'm reading from Genesis 27, 1 to 13. Now it came to pass, when Isaac was old and his eyes were so dim that he could not see, that he called Esau, his older son, and said to him, "My son." And he answered, "Here I am." Then he said, "Behold, now I am old. I do not know the day of my death. Now, therefore, please take your weapons, your quiver and your bow, and go out to the field and hunt game for me, and make me savory food such as I love, and bring it to me that I may eat, that my soul may bless you before I die." Watch this. Watch this helper. Now Rebekah was listening when Isaac spoke to Esau, his son. Now, you know what? I want you all to help me read this part, because I want you to pay particular attention to this helper. Let's read it together. Go. No, you can do louder. I want to hear you louder. Do it like when you are busy, trying to make a point. All right, let's go together. Go. Now Rebecca was listening when Isaac spoke to Esau, his son. And Esau went to the field to hunt game and to bring it. Go to the next verse. What happened? So Rebecca, number one, she listened. Number two, she spoke. Who did she speak to? Esau? Oh, my Lord. Who did she speak to? My Lord. Who did Isaac speak to? Isaac spoke to? Who is Rebecca speaking to? What did Rebecca do? She listened. You know how when you are talking, I know Regina doesn't do that. No, she doesn't. I know when you are talking to someone and they act that they are not listening, but they are listening. Isaac is having a one-on-one chat with Esau. But mom was hanging around the corner somewhere, busy trying to cook, you know, like moving the dishes around. No, they are listening. Bro, be careful what you say. There's a serious tape recorder around the corner. Rebecca listened to everything. And remember, she did not say one word to Isaac. She did not say anything. After everything was done, and Esau had gone to the field to bring what daddy asked for, a helper popped up. He said, "I need to help this boy. He carries a prophecy on his life, but he doesn't even know he carries a prophecy. He carries God's will on his life, but he's just about to miss it. Papa is being very traditional. It has to move from Abraham to Isaac to Esau. That's what tradition says. But heaven has declared, when they were both in my womb, that it will go to the younger one, that the younger shall be stronger, that the older shall serve the younger. But Papa is just about to blow it all because tradition is taking over. May God deliver you from tradition." Your amen can be better. I said, may God deliver you from tradition. May God deliver you from things that bind you, from things that you feel you have to, in the name of culture. I tell you something about this God. He defies culture. He defies tradition. He defies what human beings think. When God says he will do it, he will do it. And any way he has to move to bring you a helper who will be listening in the kitchen while Papa is talking to Esau, because at this point, Jacob is about to miss it all. But a helper popped up. I never saw it that way until God said, "Let me teach you." Every time you preach from the scripture, you just think that mom intervened. No, that was a helper. May God grant you a helper. Yes. Can I hear you say, Lord, grant me a helper. Let me tell you what Rebecca spoke to Jacob, her son, saying, indeed, I heard your father speak to Esau, your brother. And what did he say? Go to the next verse. Bring me game and make me savory food for me that I may eat and bless you in the presence of the Lord before my death. Now, therefore, my son, obey my voice. He said, this is not a suggestion. This is an order. Obey my voice. Oh my, may God grant you a helper like that. Oh my Lord. I said, may God grant you a helper like that. There are helpers who, when they come your way, they are not wishy-washy. They come there firm and strong. They come there knowing divine agenda over your life. And their job is to make sure, as it is in heaven, it shall be so here on earth. May God grant you a helper like that. May God grant, say, Lord, grant me a helper. Moment and pray in the Holy Ghost. Go ahead. Pray like you mean business. Call helpers your way. You say, but you are preaching. Why are you praying? We do everything together. Yes. Yes. Say, Lord, grant me my helper. Rebecca said, listen, son, listen to me. This is not a suggestion. It's an order. He said, now, therefore, obey my voice. According to what I command you. Okay. It was a command. What did she say? Go to the next verse. Go now to the flock and bring me from there two choice kids of the goats, and I'll make savory food from them for your father, such as he loves. Listen, I've been married to your father for years. I know what food he likes. I can cook it better. I've been cooking for him before you and Esau showed up. I know what daddy loves. He said, you get me what I'm telling you. I will take the rest. I will prepare for daddy. Because in case you don't know, I just didn't give birth to you. But I am your destiny helper right here. I am making sure God positioned me in such a way that when daddy was speaking to Esau, I could have been out there in the field. I could have been anywhere. I could have been attending a function. But I was there when they had the conversation. I heard it. Sometimes God will cause people to hear certain things for your sake. And when they hear it, may they help you. I said, may they help you. I said, may divine help come your way. May divine helpers come your way. The ways of God are more than we can think. So he said, your ways are not my ways and your thoughts are not my thoughts. You can criticize Rebecca all you want, but I can tell you in Malachi 1:2, God said, Esau, I hate, Jacob, I love. You can criticize Rebecca all you want, but when she went to pray in Genesis 25, it was she who heard what God said. Yes. When divine helpers come your way, they come with full conviction. Yes. They come with full divine orders. May God send you helpers. I said, may God send you helpers. I can't hear your amen well. I said, may Jehovah send you helpers. Can I hear a resounding amen? May Jehovah send you helpers. A helper can show up on the job. A helper can show up in your marriage. A helper can show up in school. A helper can show up on the way. A helper can show up in church. Somebody can just meet you and the person will say, I don't know why I'm doing this, but I feel like helping you. That is a helper right there. I release them into your life. Helpers can come and turn your finances around. Helpers can come and turn your home around. Helpers can come and turn your schooling around. You just need to meet one lecturer, one teacher, who takes interest in you, and he can turn you around and make you the best student. May God send you such helpers. That interview you attended, you just need one person out of the whole panel who will speak on your behalf. One person, one voice who will say, I don't even know why I'm doing this, but I just feel like helping this guy. I'm trying small, small. Please be seated in his presence. Maturiva zevreha. Oh, matevreha yavere. Matolelele. Can I hear you say, Lord? This is prayer. When I do these things, I'm asking you to pray. Say, Lord, send me my help. Somebody's husband is on the way to her. I just prophesied. I said, somebody's husband is on the way to locate you. You can say amen better. Somebody's wife is on the way to locate you. You can say amen better. A business is about to locate you. You can say amen better. I said somebody's promotion is about to just find you. You can say amen better. Somebody is about to tap into some help that doesn't even make sense. There are some help that doesn't even make sense. People help you and it doesn't make sense. It doesn't even make sense. One of my daughters shared with me yesterday, a colleague who used to just sit by her on the job, watch how hard she worked, got promoted to be a manager, sent her an email last week out of nowhere. He said, what's going on? Have they made you permanent yet? He said, no. He said, I'm now a manager. I'm transferring to my division. Once I get you there, I will make you permanent. And I got started right now. I mean, can you say, Lord, send me my helper. I feel the helpers are coming into this house. Let angels help you. Let human beings help you. Let people help you. Meanwhile, her own manager says, no, I can help you. I can't do it. Even though she's in what you guys call a pool. I don't know what that pool is. When I say water pool or whatever pool, whatever pool it is, she's in that pool. And someone needs to pull her out of that water. And the whole manager says, no, I can't help you. Another manager says, I'm transferring. I've already started the process. Join me in 2 weeks' time. I'll bring you to my section, and then I'll make you permanent immediately. Because one day she was sitting by her desk and she was crying. And this daughter of mine went and said, how can I help you? And helped her. He said, that thing. Say, Lord, send me my helpers. Oh, my Lord, I feel like preaching this morning. I really didn't want to preach because I preached at the bridge and that was enough for her. I did enough work for the week. And so I just wanted to have a little nice sermon this morning. But the Holy Ghost will let me. May God send you a helper. I tell him a summer. May God send you a helper. Let helpers locate you. Let helpers find you. Masuvarehalena. You may please be seated. Matoveri bahaya. Rasumande veyebereha. You'll be trying to be able to get that woman to love you. And no matter what you do, it's not happening. You just need one helper, some friend, somebody close who will just speak on your behalf, some brother, some sister. May God send you a helper. You've been trying to get that boy, it's not working. You just need one of his guys, one of his dudes to be used like Rebecca, to hear I heard and do what I command, and get me a goat. Let me prepare the venison that your father loves, and the helper comes. Oh, let me close. Next week we'll preach. Maturi maso. No, next week we'll preach. He said, go now to the flock and bring me from there two choice goats, and I'll make the venison, the food for your father, such as he loves. Who knows the food Isaac loves more than Rebecca? Talk to me. I like the way Deacon you put it. Only Rebecca, nobody else. When God sends you a helper, the type of helper he will send you will be the only one who can do it for you. Remember what Jacob needed was food. The only woman who knows how to cook that type of food with the proper spices, with the proper mix, with the proper barbecue, the proper temperature, the proper texture. Little blood here, pink, whatever you guys call it. I want the barbecued, whatever. What do you call it? Medium what? Jacob has no clue how to do that. But Rebecca has been doing that for Papa for many years. He says, I know the food he loves. So you are a young man, you've been out there in the field. I don't think you have any clue what's going on. But I know the food. Get it to me. Let me do it for you. Give it to me. I want to tell you one more thing. Go to the next verse. Then you shall take it to your father. that he may eat it, that he may bless you before his death. Oh. Can I go deeper? Yes. Now, who is Isaac to Rebecca? Who is Isaac to Rebecca? What's the relationship? What's the relationship? Watch this. She is telling her son, I'm about to be a widow. But before I be a widow, I want you to carry the blessing. So make the food that Papa likes, but you don't know how to make it. I will help you. I'll make it for you. When I make it, carry it to Papa. Papa is waiting to eat and to die. So I'm ready to be a widow for your blessing's sake. And I'm going to make you that food. Carry it to him. The scripture is very clear that he may eat it and bless you before he dies. Jacob is really struggling with this instruction. Go to the next verse. I'll prove something to you. And Jacob said, he's struggling. Remember, mom said, obey my voice. Do it. But Jacob, the young man is struggling. Something is going on in his mind. Then Jacob said to Rebecca, look, Esau, my brother, is a hairy man. And I'm a smooth-skinned man. Go to the next verse. Perhaps my father will feel me, and I shall seem to be a deceiver to him, and I shall bring a curse on myself and not a blessing. Is that a legitimate concern? Yes. It's a practical concern. Many of you are very concerned about practical stuff. Enjoy them. You know, I'm going to be pragmatic. Be pragmatic. But the woman who had God, when the two nations were battling in her womb, knows what she had. He said, son, you can be as practical and pragmatic all you want. I'll go to the next verse. I want to tell you something. But his mother said to him, let your curse be on me. We have moved to another level. This is no longer dealing with food stuff. We are dealing with blessings and curses. He says, if Papa decides to curse you, when the curse is pronounced upon you, I transfer the curse from your life to mine. A helper. A helper. They are called divine helpers. When they come your way, even curses, they will carry for you. Oh my Lord. Yahweh komarando heyamato lebakea. Say, Lord. Yell at it like you mean it. Say, Lord. Send me my helpers. He said, let your curse be on me, my son. Only obey my voice. Go get them for me. Just obey my voice. If it is a blessing, you keep it. If it is a curse, let me take it. When helpers come your way, it is for better or for worse. When helpers come your way, they are not there for what they can get. They are there for what they can give. When helpers come your way, they are not there to manipulate you. They are there to push you into divine agenda. May God grant you helpers. I said, may God grant you helpers. I said, may God grant you. I feel in this service, in the next few minutes, as I wind up, that angelic divine helpers are coming this way. That helpers are coming this way. Some of them may be human. Some of them may be angels. Because you know what? Abraham, before I come back to conclude, Abraham sent his servant Eliezer to go look for a wife for Isaac. And he said to Eliezer, the angel of God will go before you. But we never saw any angel recorded in the Bible. The only one we saw was a Rebecca who showed up. Rebecca herself was a product of help. So she understood what it is to help. God positioned her to help fulfill a pronouncement, someone's destiny. Bible says when Isaac saw Rebecca, he was comforted. She was an embodiment of help. She understood that my son Jacob carries, oh my Lord, a prophetic pronouncement. But Papa is about to mess it all up. But I can't blame Papa, because Papa is very traditional. Papa must obey divine rule, customary rules. The custom says it must go to the firstborn. So Papa is just fulfilling it. Papa just wants to be fair. But can I tell you something? Favor is not fair. Oh my God. If favor were to be fair, God would not say, Jacob, I love, Esau, I hated. Favor, we get the word favorite from it, right? From favorite, we get favoritism. Many of you hate favoritism. I love it. Because from favoritism, I get favor. You know, God, give me divine favor, give me, but I hate favoritism. Listen, then, don't ask for favor. Because favor means God bypassing somebody to get to you. That's what favor is. And in divine calendar, in divine agenda, in divine ways, there will be Jacob I love, Esau I hate. If you have a problem with it, tough. Go and ask God, not me. We are here to discover the ways of God, not to try to make out who God is. Because in our mind, yeah, everything has to be fair. Who told you it's fair? If things were fair, do you think you'd be where you are? My daughter here got promoted. You jumped 3 ranks. The manager who hired you, you replaced her. So you and her are on the same level. Is it fair?
No, it's not.
So those of you who think that everything must be fair, I just blew your theory away. Because when divine hand locates you, divine hand will say, Jacob, I love, Esau, I hate. But before that, there needs to be a Rebecca, a mix to be your divine helper. That's what this morning I want you to ask God for. In the next few minutes, please pray like you mean business. I'm telling you, from nowhere, a sister from this house becomes a divine helper. Locates him right now in the office of a director general or something like that, with literally zero effort. When helpers come your way, I said, when helpers come your way, processes are bypassed. Yes. Traditions are bypassed. Yes. Systems are bypassed. Yes. You will see an 80-year-old church called TLC, and it feels like, why do they have all these things? How can they be this big? And yet we're all over the world. Because when God decides to do something and he decides to help you, he doesn't have to go through traditions. He is God. May divine helpers locate you. Amen. Rebecca will say, son, even if it is a curse, let it come on me. If it is a blessing, you keep. As a divine helper. So, Jacob does everything. He gets the blessing. He leaves home. We don't hear very much about Rebecca after that. She came, fulfilled her assignment, left the scene. The helpers will come your way. They will do what they are assigned to do for you. They will leave the scene. The helpers will come your way. They will help you throughout. The helpers will come your way. They will help you to a certain point. They will leave you. The helpers will come your way. They will help you till death do you part. The helpers will come your way, and they will never leave you nor forsake you. Divine helpers. Are you ready to ask God for a divine helper? This ones you need to pray for it. Listen, there are helpers who, when they come your way, they explode your destiny. All God did was to bring me in contact with one helper, Bishop Lai, my father. The man met me. He said, "I don't know why, but I love you." I am sitting in his office. His wife is sitting right beside him. I'll never forget the scene. I am there. I'm not absent. I'm right there. The wife said to him, "No, you can't take him on like that. You can't love him like that. He can't be your son. You just met him. You don't know him." Bishop Light tells them, he said, "Mama, God spoke to me about him last night." The wife says, "No, you have never done this before. That's not how we do this. This is..." Bishop Lai looked at the wife and said, "Mama," tapped her, said, "Mama, this one is different." I will never forget that scenario. Ordinarily, they will make this argument when nobody else is there. But I'm sitting there. God says, "I want you to watch it." So for a long time, Mama didn't know whether to accept me or reject me. And I just kept loving her and blessing her. Now I'm her best son. Because in her mind, Bishop Lai doesn't do that. That's great, Bishop Lai. He never takes anybody in like that. No way. No way. The guy pastors a 30,000 member church. His own staff members. We met one who had worked with him for 4 years. He said, "I've never said hi to him, ever. He's worked for him for 4 years. You can't even see him." Mama says, "You can't." He said, "You just met him. You don't even know who he is. You don't know his..." Bishop said, "No. God spoke to me about him in the night." All he did was to put me on his platform to speak at a word explosion. One sermon. 5 years ago. One sermon. I don't even remember what I preached. The whole world exploded to me. One sermon. One. May God send you a helper. May that helper speak for you in the midst of opposition. Whether it's from the wife or from the husband or from son or daughter. When the helper speaks, let there be supernatural confirmation. May God send you people who speak for you. Please stand to your feet. I'm going to give you 2-3 minutes. And I want you to pray like you've never prayed before. Ask God for a divine helper. Because when a divine helper shows up, when a divine helper shows up, your name changes from Miss to Mrs. When a divine helper shows up, you become a mister in the proper sense, like Uber. When a divine helper shows up, they will look at you and you'll be the most beautiful woman they've ever seen. When a divine helper shows up, you be the man of their dreams. When a divine helper shows up, they will even forget any negative thing about you. All you need is one divine helper.